much for joining us. Hello, I'm Lucas McFadden. Happy Thursday to you. A York County icon receiving the Order of the Palmetto. That's the highest honor given to a South Carolina resident. The latest honoree, Kerwood Chapel. We'll get to him in a minute. But that right there is South Carolina Governor Henry McMaster visiting the Front Porch Restaurant in Richburg here in Chester County to hand deliver that award to Chapel. Chapel, who is 95 years old, served 11 consecutive terms on the York County Council. That's 22 years total. Chapel says he is not a politician, but rather a public servant. In addition to being on the York County Council, Chapel has worn many hats, mainly that of a veterinarian. Here is Chapel reacting to receiving the Order of the Palmetto.
For me today in my honor, this is the first time I've ever been honored in my life in all my 22 years of political correction. Political career. But I thank you very much. I've had all my life and I had a lot of studying. I had a lot of court action against me and my profession, and I won everything due to the public, like you are here today supporting me. Only the cow and the mule and the hog and the dog knew what I was doing to govern you.
Anyone who's lived in York County knows Dr. Chapel, a self-made man who created a successful business and became an iconic statesman.
Amen.
His work ethic is unmatched, and after 95 years, his accomplishments are many. Whether you know him as a local school bus driver, farmer, businessman, landowner, veterinarian, pilot, legendary statesman, or a trusted neighbor and friend, he is unapologetically authentic. Some folks call me the successor to Kerwood Chapel, but everybody in this room knows nobody can fill those shoes. I do want to say thank you to Governor McMaster for recognizing the achievements of Dr. Chapel. To me, there is nobody on this earth that is more deserving of this award than Kerwood Chapel.
Kerwood is smart as he can be, but he's plain spoken. Some people might not recognize that high intelligence. He's strong as a bull, but gentle as a lamb. Mm-hmm. He's slow to anger, but don't get him mad. He's loyal to his friends, he's devoted to his country, and there's no man in his mind, no man is his superior, but neither is any man his inferior. He has respect for everybody.
How about that? Kerwood Chapel is the seventh Chester County resident to receive the Order of the Palmetto. His farm straddles both Chester and York counties. Well, during his time on the York County Council, Chapel took steps to help improve the quality of life when it comes to making sure we have plenty to do here. The Rock Hill Parks, Recreation, and Tourism Department is here now with a rundown of activities taking place, starting with the upcoming Rock Hill Christmas Parade.
The parade itself is December 6th. It starts at 6:30, the usual parade route. We're talking about it now because we will open the applications for entries on September 25th. So, you know when Christmas is. So September 25th is when we're opening online for applications. That's at 8 a.m. And you do that at cityofrockhill.com/parade. Want to give you a few tips for getting ready to fill that out, because the parade, we do have limited space, mainly due to the limited space in the staging area on Oakland Avenue. And it often fills up in a few days. So please, if you really want to be in it, hop on it the first day on September 25th and get your application in. Some tips to prepare, like anything online, set up your account. If you've not already signed up for something through Parks, Recreation, and Tourism, go ahead and set up your account in advance. Or, sometimes we see it's groups that get together. So do some planning. Who, you know, if you all are, you know, who, Lucas, are you going to do it? Ashley, are you going to, who's going to actually do it? Have that plan. Get the account set up. You will need to enter in a description of your entry. So have a plan for that. You know, what is it you're going to be doing? Is there a theme to it? Are there going to be costumes? How many lights, especially? It is a lighted evening parade, so we need to see some lights. So we want to hear a brief description, but just get that together. And then the length of the entry as well. So, and that's how we space everything out and be sure we have space for however many entries we end up with. So if it's a truck and it's pulling a trailer and there's some space in between, we need to know what that full front-to-back measurement is. So if you have that ready, I think sometimes we've seen people start an application, never finish it because maybe they're going to figure this out, and then maybe they forget to come back and finish it. And that is crushing when you know, they realize they've not finalized everything. So now we're talking about seniors. The Senior Health Fair is this month, September 19th, at the Sports and Events Center. It begins at 10 a.m. It is free. Parking is free, too, now over there, by the way, as long as you're parking in parking deck A or B, not under the building itself, at least during the daytime. The Senior Health Fair will have over 40 vendors who serve seniors. There will be health screenings, an exercise demonstration, and something new this year we're very excited about. We are partnering with Victory Gardens. They're going to be doing a couple of diabetic cooking workshops during the health fair. These are free, but there is limited space in the room that they'll be in, so you do need to register for that advance. You can do that at our website as well. There'll be raffles and prizes, and it's just a great time. Yeah. So love September that. 19th, Sports and Events Center at 10 a.m. Senior Health Fair.
And Miracle League is getting ready to kick off. I got my volunteer email yesterday.
Good job.
Can't
Terry
wait. Hagen. That's
yeah.
right.
I think we've had both of our volunteer trainings already. Mm-hmm. But if you are a volunteer and you're trained, the link will go up later this afternoon on the website. You probably did get an email.
Yep.
You've already done it. I have as well. But just a reminder of those, the games are still Saturday mornings, those are the youth games at 9, 10, and 11. Wednesday evenings are the adult games at 6 and 7. The season begins September 18th.
If you want to try volleyball for free, well, it's bouncing your way.
Yeah, that's literally what this clinic is called. Try volleyball for free. It is being put on by USA Volleyball, who is one of our partners, and they are the event organizers for a lot of the weekend volleyball tournaments that are at the Sports and Events Center. But this clinic will be Saturday, September 21st. It is for youth in grades 2nd through 7th grade. It begins at 9:15 in the morning, goes until noon. You do have to pre-register. Again, I think they just have a certain number of spots available, and you can do that at cityrockhill.com/PRT under Youth Athletics, or you can go to our Facebook page. We have a post about it as well.
And then lifelong learning?
Yeah, just a quick plug. Those classes, the fall semester started this week. There are still some seats available in some sessions. So just cityrockhill.com/lifelong learning if you want to get registered.
And CN2 Now continues right after this.
So much of your day is spent waiting. Waiting for the train, waiting in line, waiting for things to download. The last thing you want to do is wait for hot water. End the wait. Rinnai tankless water heaters with SmartCirc intelligent recirculation provide you with unlimited hot water when you need it.
Stop waiting. Get expert sales advice and installation at York County Natural Gas.
When it comes to prescription medications and health needs, Rock Hill residents have been turning to Good Pharmacy for over 50 years.
I've been coming to Good Pharmacy since we came to Rock Hill in 1984, and I would not change pharmacists for anything.
With their knowledgeable staff, you can always trust that your prescription will be filled with complete confidence and care for your health. Good Pharmacy, conveniently located at the corner of Ebenezer Road and Camden Avenue.
Thank you. What's the best way to attract a wide variety of beautiful birds to your backyard? By offering the birds the right foods in expertly designed bird feeders from Wild Birds Unlimited. Whether you've been feeding the birds for a while or are just getting started, let our backyard bird feeding specialists show you how to add a little joy to your life and make nature a part of every day. Shop now for exclusive bird foods, feeders, hardware, and more. Wild Birds Unlimited. Products designed by experts. Trusted local advice.
When it comes to prescription medications and health needs, Rock Hill residents have been turning to Good Pharmacy for over 50 years.
I've been coming to Good Pharmacy since we came to Rock Hill in 1984, and I would not change pharmacists for anything.
With their knowledgeable staff, you can always trust that your prescription will be filled with complete confidence and care for your health. Good Pharmacy, conveniently located at the corner of Ebenezer Road and Camden Avenue.
Welcome back to CN2 Now. The Rock Hill Symphony Orchestra is kicking off its seventh season this Saturday. Here is the conductor, Christopher James Lees, who is giving us some insight on how he prepares for his concerts as a marathon runner.
Yeah, I'm a marathoner. I recently took that up. I've run two marathons so far, Boston Marathon this last April, Chicago coming up in October, and it keeps me busy and make sure that I'm always moving, whether or not I'm on or off the podium.
I was about to say, you do move a lot when you're on the podium as well. We have seen you in action, so it's just par for the course.
Yeah, our last Rock Hill Symphony concert, Masterworks concert, I did 17 miles in the morning, dress rehearsal in the afternoon, concert that night, and then another 10 the next day.
Yeah.
And it's wild. Nobody
All
should
right,
ever do that.
There you go. He's setting the bar.
Challenge accepted. Next time you'll join me.
I mean, most of the time, Lucas is like the most fit one in the room. I think he's got you beat this time.
I think you wear the crown, and please wear it proudly for sure. That's crazy. I'm never going to complain at all about my hour and a half or hour fitness routine, and I'm usually tired for the rest of the day. But it just goes to show that you can do a lot, and your brain works in that way, right? Like you probably enjoy the runs, and the artistic side of your brain is also taking a break for a moment, and then when you need to exercise that, you're ready to go.
Yeah, and I'm lucky that my profession is aerobic, and it all reinforces itself. And when I get to think through and plan and prepare for these Rock Hill Symphony concerts, that makes the runs that much more enjoyable, because I know what people are going to experience, and it's going to be such a blast.
So if you're running, do you listen to music? If you do, what kind of music do you listen to? What do you do on your runs?
It depends on what sort of mood I'm in. I mean, you know the feeling. There's sometimes you want to be a little bit more analytical. Other times you just want to feel more deep passion and energy. And if I've got, like this year, I'm doing about 80 performances between next weekend and July 1st.
Wow.
And so there's a lot of rep to get up in my head too. So just, you know, you put whatever you need to, either Apple Music classical or high electronic dance music, and you just keep your legs moving and keep going.
Your first concert of season six?
Seven.
Lucky number seven.
Yep.
Not great with Roman numerals.
That's okay. I knew you were having trouble.
You saw the wheels moving?
I did.
Thanks,
I
Ashley.
Did. Yes.
All right, so it's season seven. It's going to kick off on September the 7th.
Yeah, 7-on-7. We have such a powerhouse program for people. We have a brand new fanfare, which was called Champions Come to Rock Hill. It was commissioned for the BMX World Championships in May, and our brass players performed it in front of city officials and all the assembled athletes, and now we're doing a full orchestra version. Our Emmy Award-winning composer, Gary Fry, who recently moved to the Carolinas, wrote it for us and then expanded it to include the strings and the woodwinds, and so we're going to kick off our program with that, and so that we hope this becomes a sort of calling card for the city in a way that fuses our athletic pursuits and aspirations with the artistic passions and soul. And so to be able to draw in all of this great energy from our city, I think it's just going to help keep Rock Hill as the main focus of all things that are possible to generate from here. And that's just the start of the program. Like, that's the first 3.5 minutes. But we've got got a guest composer coming in, Nia Imani Franklin, who is a composer and singer and conductor, but she's also Miss America from 2019.
Oh, wow.
She's a composer in her own right, and we're performing a piece of hers called Chrysalis Extended that she wrote for the Dallas Symphony. Mm. She lives in Winston-Salem, North Carolina, and so she's going to drive down and be a part of the festivities to kick off our seventh season. And then we've got another phenomenal female, an amazing soloist named Ashley Hall, who's just coming off of a residency with the Canadian Brass, one of the most premier brass ensembles in the world. She's currently in Australia performing and teaching, and then her next engagement is next weekend right here in Rock Hill, South Carolina. So she's going to play a couple of pieces, and we close the program with a showpiece of our orchestra, our musicians. We're calling it Orchestral Brilliance because the heart of great music in Rock Hill is certainly the musicians who help make it.
That's an action-packed concert.
I know. It's not something anybody wants to miss.
We're coming out of the gate strong.
You call it on the website, musical fireworks.
That's right.
That's well said. So this is Saturday, September the 7th. The pre-concert talk begins at 6:30. The concert begins at 7:30. This is all taking place, season 7, at Sullivan Middle School. That's mm-hmm. been your home for the last year or two. You can go ahead and get tickets now. It's for the whole family. Do you hope that every year that the symphony's around, that you continue to kind of break down those barriers and show folks that you can do more than one thing here in this community?
Absolutely. I think it's very natural for us to box people in and say, this is what you do, and therefore you can't do other things. And we understand commitment, certainly. But as we like to say in the running community, if you've got a body, you can be a runner. And if you have a heart and a soul, you can be an artist. And so I think music is as much a human birthright as athletic competition can be. And part of being ever more focused on becoming a whole individual, a whole city, a whole community, a whole family, it requires us to approach our own sense of wholeness. And to be able to do that through art, through music, through the shared experience next Saturday night, that even if we were to record it, you'd never be able to have that same experience again. You have to be in the room with your friends and family and neighbors to feel connected to both the music that's happening and also the city that we love living in. So it's a spectacular forum and venue through which I do hope people feel like, you know, I can be active and I can be sensitive. I can be dynamic and fast and strong, and I can also take a moment away from my digital devices and just immerse in the present moment with great artistry from music that was written 125 years ago and music that was written a few months ago.
Right. That's
all
awesome.
In the same night. These are the experiences we want people in Rock Hill to have.
And real quick, what does that experience look like to prepare for something like this? What does the orchestra do to prepare?
Yeah. Well, the difference between professional musicians and amateur musicians, as we all remember from high school band or orchestra, is like you rehearse for a long period of time and you perform once.
Yeah.
Because all of our musicians are trained professionals and they play all over the region. They get their music ahead of time, they prepare, and our first rehearsal is Thursday and our concert is Saturday. So we put this together in 48 hours.
Stay with CN2 Now. We are back right after this.
Being there for someone in their time of need is what Green Funeral Home has done compassionately for four generations. It's a privilege we take very seriously.
We believe each life should be honored and remembered by family and friends. Whether you choose traditional burial in our chapel or another venue, or cremation provided by our on-site crematory, we will help guide you through each step to ensure your needs are met.
We are also available to discuss pre-planning, peace of mind that you have helped your loved one by making those difficult decisions.
When the need arises, our family is here for your family.
Mom's pearls were a cherished gift on my wedding day. When they broke, I turned to Norman Hagee Jewelers, our family's jeweler for over 50 years. Trusted then, cherished now. Discover timeless pieces crafted with care, designed to last a lifetime, not just fleeting fashion. Norman Hagee Jewelers specializes in fine jewelry and gifts, watch and jewelry repair, and of course, pearl restringing. Experience their friendly concierge service, where every visit feels like a warm embrace. Visit Norman Hagee Jewelers today.
Live Strong at the YMCA is a lifesaver for so many people.
I love Live Strong because you meet so many people, you learn how strong you can be physically and mentally.
The camaraderie and the closeness that you feel and come together as a group is just amazing.
We meet them where they are and we work with them to help them get stronger.
At the YMCA of Upper Palmetto, we are proud to offer our community the support of the Live Strong program to all cancer survivors. For more information, visit your local branch.
80 years helping Charlottians with their roofing and gutter needs has taught us a lot, like the importance of real service. That's why when you call H&S,
good morning, this is H&S Roofing Company.
Your call will always be answered by a knowledgeable, real person. Someone who can get an expert craftsman to your home or business to get your problem solved. So when you have a roofing or gutter issue, call H&S, where you'll always talk to a real person. H&S Roofing and Gutter Company, celebrating 80 years serving the Charlotte area.
This is CN2 Now. Let's head to the town of Clover, where Sam Long is giving us a list of what's happening this weekend and beyond.
This Saturday, we have a farmer's market that's in downtown Clover. So our Clover Main Street director, Alicia Griffith, is organizing and hosting. So we had in August, we'll have September and then October. So a little series that is 9 to 1 right in Main Street, Clover. Redemption Fitness will be there. Happy Hooves will be there as well. So there will be interactive things for children to do, some animals to see and pet, which is really fun. Last time there was a donkey that had a hat on, which was really cute. So there's lots of fun.
That's
things.
Impressive. He was keeping it on. Yeah.
So lots of fun things to do while your parents shop for.
Did the hat go over his ears?
Yes,
so it was
fit.
A slot
yes,
for his
that's
ears.
Cute. Yes, it fit over his ears. Yes, that was so adorable. Cute.
What was his name?
I don't remember his name, but if you the kids would be petting in them, and then if they stopped petting them, he would let out like the loudest noise. He was a very spoiled donkey.
Oh,
clearly.
Yeah. So lots of interactive things for the children to do, and then vendors downtown to shop. So that will be the first Saturday in September and October from 9 to 1.
And will the donkey be there in October as well?
I think the donkey's here for the whole series.
Oh, that's great. You should get there.
Yes. Maybe for October he can dress in a Halloween hat.
Yeah.
He can
Halloween costume.
Yeah, that's it. He can be the donkey from Shrek.
That's cute.
Yeah, so that is going on this Saturday. So lots of fun things there at the farmer's market. And then September 19th, we will have our last Food Truck Thursday of this series. Mm. So we do that 6 months out of the year. So this will be the last one for 2024. And then September 21st, the JCs will host their Fall Festival and Auto Show. So that's a big event for them. So a car show as well as vendors. Lots of things going on that day. So that will be from 10 to 4 on September 21st. We are having a movie in the park on October 11th. We are taking votes right now. So you can go on our Facebook or our Town of Clover website and vote for which Halloween-themed movie you would like to see play that night.
And that's Casper, The Haunted Mansion, or Ghostbusters Frozen Empire.
So now, what would you do, Lucas?
I'm hitting
your vote?
I'm voting right now, Sam.
Perfect.
Haunted Mansion, done.
Haunted Mansion, okay. So that's after the ride at Disney.
Yeah.
Okay.
Is it the newer Haunted?
Yes, the 2023.
Oh, that's a good one, too.
Yeah.
Okay,
yes.
Well, we talk all the time about voting.
Yeah.
Not
the importance.
So, and we say local level, so yes. Start here at the Town of Clover. Go vote.
I wanted my voice heard.
There you go. You don't want to complain.
That's right.
Now, you have to be a good sport if your movie doesn't get chosen.
That's also
a
good point.
But you voted.
Yes.
But you did vote, so you do have a little room to say, oh, man.
So I've got to support those that pick Casper or Ghostbusters.
That's right.
Exactly.
Okay.
But you did vote, so you can say, oh, man.
Yeah, that's a great point, Ashley.
So
go ahead.
You go.
If you're nervous about voting in November, go ahead and vote. This is a simple
this
ballot.
This is a trial.
You can practice. Anybody can do it. You don't even have to be registered.
Oh, man. So the movie in the park will take place on October the 11th. Okay.
Yes, that's great.
All right.
And then we will do a Halloween event on October 31st, which is a Thursday this year. So that will be food truck and treat. So we'll have food trucks as well as local businesses and organizations set up tents and hand out candy. So if you are interested in being a food truck vendor or a candy tent, you can. We are still accepting applications for both of those. So the businesses and organizations, in the past, it's been really fun because they set up their tent and decorate however they want, and so that's really fun. Cute. This event in the past has been really well attended. So this is in partnership with the Clover Police Department and the Clover Fire Department, just to give kids a safe place to trick or treat on Halloween.
And that's on Halloween night.
Yes, it is. So that'll be 5:30 to 8:30 on Halloween, right behind the police department in Clover.
Don't go away. CN2 Now is back right after this.
Hi, I'm John Warden with Champion Services. If you're considering remodeling or making repairs to your home due to storm damage, here's a few things to ponder. A lot of folks have come in town promising a lot of things about we are here, we've been here for a long period of time, only to be found false. Choosing the right contractor is extremely important. Here at Champion Services, our goal is one thing, it's customer satisfaction. And that's just not a sentence, that's a fact. Let me say it's been a joy to serve you for over 30 years. This message is brought to you by Champion Services and CN2.
Life's full of choices. Here's a simple one.
Well, I am a bit of a minimalist.
Life's a cruise, just a move.
If you need assistance with your utility expenses, call your local Community Actions County office. The Low Income Home Emergency Assistance Program, LIHEAP, is designed to help low-income households meet their emergency home, heating, and cooling needs. LIHEAP places emphasis on serving those households whose utilities have been disconnected or at risk of disconnection. If you need assistance with your utility expenses to heat or cool your home, call your local Community Actions County office or visit us online at carolinacommunityactions.org.
I'm Catherine Faircloth with First Community Bank. Oh, doesn't every bank offer the same products and services? Yes, the difference is we are focused on businesses right here in our community. The people that we bank are the people we see in the grocery store. They're the people we see at the ball fields. They're the people we see at church. You become a partner with the customer in getting to where they want to go with their business. It is who we are that sets us apart at First Community. You can't change your DNA, can you?
You're watching CN2 Now. Here's our latest CN2 Now picture of the day, brought to you by Champion Services. Keep York County Beautiful's Leslie Hatchell, who is the recycling educator and coordinator, has been awarded the Educator of the Year by Palmetto Pride. Way to go, Leslie, and thank you so much for what you're doing and others for making sure York County looks her best. And thank you so much for joining us for CN2 Now. Have a great night.
At Founders, we know your finances matter. That's why we have loans for any reason.
Can Founders help us with our mortgage?
Of course.
Can Founders get me an
auto loan? Not a problem.
Nice.
Can we do something about this?
Home improvements? Absolutely.
How about just getting ahead?
Pay down some bills? We can do that. When you need a loan, our great low rates give you the opportunity to invest in the most important thing, you. So relax. At Founders, we're with you every step of the way.
When you're getting a bundle from Comporia, you're getting an all-seeing, all-knowing personal security detail. You're getting shows, and shows, and, oh yeah, more shows. You're getting a social calendar filled with family game time, game day get-togethers, and don't worry, we saved you a spot on the couch parties, because we're not just your internet company. We're your yes to all of the above company.
Well, hey there, your plumbing works pretty good. Let's go check your roof out.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. You want me to get up there? Forget about it.
Your roof is your home's first line of defense from outside elements. When it comes time to get it replaced or repaired, you need dependable and experienced professionals to take care of your home.
After completing your roof inspection, I would recommend a full replacement. But no worries, we will work with your insurance company.
With over 30 years of experience, Brown's Roofing is our area's most trusted contractor. To have it done right, call on the experts at Brown's Roofing Company.
When a catastrophe hits, it can be a very stressful time for you. When you have trees on your house, when you have trees on your cars, and you don't know what to do, you call us.
We're not a 1-800 number, we're an 803 number. We've been in business for over 60 years because we take care of our clients. That means taking care of them during claim situations.
We're not 9-to-5, we're 24/7. We're gonna be there when you need us most. Gill Insurance, your local auto owner's agent. Understanding business is how we do business.
What's the best way to attract a wide variety of beautiful birds to your backyard? By offering the birds the right foods in expertly designed bird feeders from Wild Birds Unlimited. Whether you've been feeding the birds for a while or are just getting started, let our backyard bird feeding specialists show you how to add a little joy to your life and make nature a part of every day. Shop now for exclusive bird foods, feeders, hardware, and more. Wild Birds Unlimited. Products designed by experts. Trusted local advice.